No, they're gone for the night, but they know you're coming, so don't worry about it.
Well, seeing as I'm already on your dad's shit list for what happened last time, I felt the need to ask.
Tina, that was months ago. He's over it.
I'm so sure he's over it. Last weekend when I was there, I go to say hi to him. He looks at me with this dead serious face, and he says, "Are you behaving?"
He was just messing with you. Trust me, my dad loves you.
God, I hope so. Your dad scares the shit out of me sometimes. He's guaranteed to be a serial killer in his next life.
You know I'm gonna tell him you said that. Then he's really not gonna like you. He'll make you his next victim.
You totally wouldn't.
We'll see. Have you even left your house yet?
On my way out the door now, if that counts.
It's good enough for me. Then I'm gonna get back to watching my movie. I'll see you in 10.
You bitch! Tell me you started watching Scream without me.
It's almost over. I've been watching it.
Just so you know, we're watching it again when I get there.
Definitely not.
All right, I'll see you in a couple minutes.
Bye. Hello?
Hello, Stacy.
Hi. Who is this?
Guess.
Well, I don't know. You called me.
Do you like scary movies, Stacy?
Are you trying to be funny?
No, I'm just trying to make a movie. Interested?
I don't think so. I didn't sign up to play this part, so I'm gonna have to cut your movie short.
Wrong! I'll be the only one doing the cutting tonight. You get to be my Drew Barrymore. And Stacy, forget watching Scream. You get to live it.
Here?
Yeah, I'm pulling into your development now.
Okay, I'll let you in.
Alright, front door of the garage.
Garage.
Okay, see you in a minute.
I swear, your house gets creepier and creepier every time I come here.
It's like someone's watching me.
Oh, so where are we staying tonight? Stace.
What?
Something wrong?
Did you call me before? Like, earlier, after we hung up?
No, you called me.
Just tell me the truth, I won't be mad.
Stacy, I promise, I didn't call you a second time.
Someone did.
Who?
He's calling again.
Here, give me the phone. Cooper Residence. Hello?
I want to talk to Stacy.
This is Stacy.
Not
gonna happen. Anything you can say to her, you can say to me.
I'm warning. giving you last chance. I called to talk to her.
Well, that's life. You can't always get what you want. So take what you got or you can go fuck yourself. Sound good?
Wrong answer.
See? That's all you gotta do with assholes like that.
But I did that.
Well, obviously not like I did.
Whatever.
So we're in the sunroom, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, this would be perfect to film a horror movie. The windows give it such a creepy vibe.
Tell me you watched the news this morning.
No, I woke up too late. Why?
You really don't know?
No, what happened?
Tina Riley and Stacy Cooper were killed last night.
Oh my God, are you serious?
News isn't lying. They had their pictures up and everything.
That's awful.
Yep. Thought I'd be the one to tell you before someone else ruined the surprise.
Gwen, that's not funny.
What? Stacy Cooper was a fucking bitch, and you know it. Sorry if I have no remorse for dead bitches.
You're horrible.
Thank you.
What makes a true horror film? Or at least today's generation's definition of it. Jason.
It's a lot of blood, guts, gore, jump scares.
Correct. In today's generation, that is a true horror. But in this room, with all of you that love horror films so much, do you agree with that? Ian, do you agree?
No.
Why not?
Well, Jason's right. Today, when people think of horror films, they think of movies like Saw, Hostel, torture porn, movies that are all about gore. But that's not true horror. I don't think anybody knows what true horror really is these days.
Interesting. So what would you say is a movie that exhibits true horror?
Movies that deal with the viewer's nightmares, hidden terrors, and fear of the unknown.
Excellent answer. Now what about a slasher film? Is that a horror film? Or in a genre all of its own?
Can I just throw something out there real quick?
Go ahead, Julie.
Don't you think right now probably isn't the best time to be teaching this lesson?
No, I don't. Would you like to explain to the rest of the class why you don't feel we should learn today?
I mean, two girls, girls that we all know, were butchered last night. And now we're sitting here talking about slasher films.
All right, I see where you're coming from, but the lesson's been planned for weeks, and I really just... Does anybody else in here feel we shouldn't learn today?
Well, I for one think this is the best.
Why do you have to be such an asshole?
Cool it, Julie.
As I was saying, have you ever thought about how movies affect people?
Yes.
Well, think of this. This town has never seen a murder like this before. But what's in the movie theater right now? Jason, you work at the movie theater. What just came out last week?
Scream 4?
Exactly. Movies affect the way people think. A slasher film came out last weekend, and this weekend, two girls are stabbed to death.
They deserve to die.
Sorry, what was that, Colin?
I said they deserve to die. They're whores anyway.
Colin, nobody deserves to die.
They did.
All right, we'll pick up tomorrow. Remember to bring your notebooks, okay?
Bye, guys. See you later. Bye. Later, guys. Natalie, can I talk to you for a second?
Yeah, sure.
I'll write you a pass to your next class.
Okay.
Here, sit down.
What's up? You okay?
Yeah, I'm totally fine.
Sure?
Yeah.
Listen, your guidance counselor told me about the divorce.
It's okay. I wanted to let you know it's alright if you're confused and upset.
I know what you went through. My parents got divorced right around my 16th birthday.
How did you handle it?
Well, I stopped blaming myself and realized there was nothing I did wrong. So, if you are blaming yourself, you don't have to. It's alright.
I know, I'm trying.
I see that. Good. But if you need anyone to talk to or listen to you, I'm always here. You know where to find me, okay?
Thanks, Miss Conway. It really means a lot.
Let me get you that pass, okay?
Okay.
Hey! Oh, Jesus, Gwen!
What?
Do you have to pop out at me like that?
Someone's jumpy today.
Well, who would it be with all the murders?
Ooh, because some psycho killer's gonna go off in the middle of the hallway? Highly unlikely.
What were you doing waiting outside the door anyway?
I was waiting for you. And trying to listen to your conversation.
Yeah, I thought so. You're gonna be late to class.
Oh, no problem. I've got it covered. There. Problem solved. We're in the same class anyways.
It's the two different handwritings.
So what? Mr. Kazakov is blind. It's my senior year, and frankly, I don't give a fuck.
I know that much.
So, what'd Miss Conway want?
Nothing, she's just concerned.
Because of the murders? What, does she think you're next or something?
It's not funny. No, she's just asking about my parents.
Oh. Sorry.
Oh, no, it's okay. I mean, it's nothing to be sorry about. It's their business, not mine.
Right.
Kind of feels weird with a murderer on the loose and all.
Think of it like this, don't you? Don't you think we'd be safer if we were together?
True. Yeah, you know what? Fuck it. Just gotta worry about keeping my brother out of the house now.
He's cool as hell, man. He doesn't care if you have a couple people.
No, dude, you don't know. He's been acting weird as hell lately. But if he finds out about this shit, there's no way that he'll let us over.
Let's hope he didn't watch the news. Who's coming anyway?
Gwen, Natalie, I think Jason. Shane! Shane! What? Are you coming to my party tomorrow night? Yeah, we'll be there. Alright. Shane and April are coming.
I know, I heard that. I fucking hate them.
Shane and April? Why?
They're so fucking annoying with all their happy couple smiley bullshit. I'm over it. No matter where they go, they're always all over each other.
Just jealous that you and Gwen don't have that type of relationship.
She beats me. I'm serious, dude. I mean, they have a great relationship. She's abusive.
Yeah, I bet.
What's up with you and Natalie?
What? Nothing's going on, man.
Don't bullshit with me. Everybody knows you're, like, in love with her.
Shut up, Frankie.
Don't deny it. I mean, there's nothing wrong with it, I just don't think she likes you too.
Believe me, I know she doesn't like me like that, but... Cause you know what I am to her? Just that nerdy kid in her film class. She's never gonna look at me that way.
Sure. You're too hard on yourself. I mean, you guys are still good friends, you're not just some nerd.
Whatever, dude, I just wanna get the fuck out of here! Ugh, 2 more hours in this hellhole and we're free.
Sadly, I think so.
It's cool if I chill and work on my video.
Are you gonna piss me off?
Nope.
All right, go ahead.
Sweet.
Don't even think about it. Leave Colin alone.
Today has been the longest day ever.
Tell me about it.
Every single one of my fucking classes, we just sat there and stared at the wall.
My teachers thought that, you know, out of respect, we should take a day off and sit in silence. Like, fuck that. I mean, who gives a shit? They died. What do you fucking do?
Easy there, Gwen. You're starting to sound a little bit like Colin. And you're getting chips all over Jason's car.
He's an asshole.
Wait, what was up with Colin before? Like, why did he say that?
He's a fucking creep. He always has been.
You know, I bet he's the one who did it. After what he said today, it's definitely him.
No way. He doesn't have the balls to kill someone.
Ah, and you do.
Well, if I was face to face with a psycho and his knife, yeah.
You say that now. Come on, Gwen. We know you have a soft side.
Don't you dare.
Well, Frankie, you should be the one to talk. I mean, you wouldn't survive either.
And you would? You're just some dumb fucking blonde who can't do anything for herself. You just sit there waiting on your fucking boyfriend. Where is Shane anyway?
He had dinner with his parents. He had to go home.
Then why are you even here?
Sometimes I don't know.
April, he didn't mean that.
Of course I did. I wouldn't have said it if I didn't mean it.
Goodbye, Natalie.
April, don't go.
Let her go. She doesn't need to be here.
Why do you have to be like that? You know that she's that sensitive.
She's a senior in high school. It's about time she grows up already.
You know what, Frankie? I'm friends with you and everything, but sometimes you're really just an asshole. Gwen, can you take me home now?
So, I'll see you tonight?
Not after that. You can text me and maybe I'll answer.
Come on, Gwen. It's not like I was a dick to you.
Bye, Ian.
Bye. Natalie!
Yeah?
I didn't really get to talk to you today.
Is something wrong?
No, it's just I wanted to talk to you, see if you're okay. Gwen told me about your parents.
Oh.
I just want to let you know if there's anything you need. I'm here for you.
Thanks. It really means a lot. I'll see you tomorrow.
All right, see you.
What?
Oh, nothing. I just wasn't expecting that.
Me neither.
Well, Ian really likes you.
I see, really.
It's like fucking puppy dog love.
What's up?
Nothing.
How was school?
Yeah, it was fine.
Yeah.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna head out to my girlfriend's for a couple of days. You gonna be right while I'm gone?
Yeah. Be fine.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, you got mom and dad's numbers.
Yeah.
Make sure you give them a call.
Be fine.
Yeah. Love you, bro.
Love you too, man.
Hey, you got my number if you need anything.
Yes, man, I'll be fine.
Good.
It's really good.
Thanks.
I mean, I like it a lot. It's very different than what you normally do, but it's really, really well done.
Yeah, I was trying something new. I mean, since it's like one of my last projects and all.
All right, but listen, let's wrap it up. I gotta get home, okay? I'm done grading my papers. You guys shut down and you can finish up tomorrow in class, okay?
Bye, Sandwich.
Bye, Jason. Let's go, Colin. I want to get out of here. Colin!
Goodbye, Miss Colin.
Goodbye, Colin. Hello?
What's your favorite scary movie?
Sorry?
You seem to enjoy scary movies, so you have to have a favorite.
Is this what I get for giving my number out to students? Who is this?
I asked you a question, and until you answer mine, don't expect me to answer yours.
Poltergeist.
Plain and boring. Clown under the bed? I've never been a fan.
Well, then you don't know what true horror is.
Is that so?
Poltergeist was a classic. What's yours?
Guess.
I'll
give you a hint. It's a 90s slasher.
Candyman?
That's hardly a slasher. This film you failed to mention during the class discussion earlier.
Okay, listen. I don't have time for this shit. You can either tell me or I'm gonna hang up.
It's Scream.
I am never going to let you stay after and work in my classroom again. That's right. Jason, I know it's you. I'm hanging up now.
I wouldn't do that if I were you. The last person who hung up on me is fucking dead. Besides, I want this to be more fun.
Who the fuck is this?
You never wanted to set up a teaching film. That was never your dream. You wanted real big screen Hollywood work. Well, congratulations. You've just earned yourself your first starring role.
Truth, honestly, like, you're my only real friend besides Shane. He's my boyfriend, so it doesn't really even count.
Oh, don't say that. I mean, you definitely have more friends than just me.
No, you don't. But, I have a lot of homework that I have to do, and then I'm gonna go to bed, so.
Okay.
Alright. Thank you. You know, it's great that I have a friend that cares about me this much. So, see you tomorrow.
Shoes on.
Yeah, but you're not going anywhere.
Yeah, I am. My friend's here, and I'm staying over at his house tonight, so bye.
Robbie, Mom said you're not allowed to leave the house, and it's a school night anyway. Robbie, can you hear me? The only
Jesus,
reason-
I heard you. Jesus Christ. You know, it's times like this when I wish you weren't my sister.
Hello?
Hey.
Who's this?
Shane, really?
What's up, April?
Nothing. I just wanted someone to talk to. How was the dinner?
It was fine. Just got home about an hour ago. Is everything okay with you?
Yeah, everything's fine. Just Robbie's being an asshole and decided to leave. So now I'm all alone.
You want to talk about it?
No, it's fine. With the murders and all. It's a little creepy.
Where are your parents?
They went away, remember, to the new house?
Just me and Robbie for the whole week.
Don't forget to set the alarm.
Shane, that's so not funny!
You're right, I'm sorry. Do you want me to come over?
Could you?
I don't see why not. Now that I'm finally 18, my mother lets me do anything I want. All right, I'll see you in about 20 minutes.
Yeah, just
hurry, okay?
Okay. See you soon.
Bye. Call back. Someone forgot to say I love you.
Hello, April.
Who is this?
You tell me.
Shane, is that you?
Scary night, isn't it? With the murders and all, it's like right out of a horror movie or something.
Nice try, Jason. That line was right from the first Scream film. Didn't think I'd know that, did you?
I'm impressed. I expected much less from you. Let's not drag this on longer than it has to. I've already had my fun tonight. So if you, I'll just cut right to the chase.
What do you mean?
Why don't you take a look at your caller ID? You'll know exactly what I mean.
Who is this? How'd you get Stacy's phone?
I took it right after I ripped my knife from her throat.
That's not funny.
And who said I was trying to be funny? This isn't a fucking comedy, it's a horror film. People live, people die, and you better stop playing.
Hey, what's up? I'm on my way now.
Shannon, you need to drive faster.
Why? What's wrong?
There's someone in my house. They called for Stacy's traffic.
Did you see anyone?
Brother's room.
Okay, all right, April, I want you to listen to me.
Get into your car and drive away. If the car's gone, I'll know you're safe, okay? Okay?
Okay.
April.
I love you.
I love you too.
Last night's brutal murders, proving this to be the work of a serial killer. Here are the facts. Young teen Stacy Cooper and Tina Riley were the first victims. The murders continue with two other students and a teacher from Howell High School. April Harris and Shane Phillips were attacked in their homes earlier, leaving one dead and the other seriously injured. If that weren't enough, the body of beloved school teacher Rachel Conway was discovered at the school early this morning. Miss Conway's body was discovered wearing the mask of this familiar face. This ghost face mask is commonly known to be worn by the iconic killer in the horror movie franchise Scream. And with Scream 4 just hitting theaters last week, it appears that the killer's trying to make a fan film of his own. So who's next? All Howell Township schools will be closed until further notice.
So what, you expect me to feel sorry about what I said because she's fucking dead?
No, but I expect you to show a little bit of common courtesy for those of us who do care.
Well, right now it looks like you're the only one.
That's not true. There's her family, there's Shane.
Are any of them here right now? Can any of them hear what I'm saying?
Can you please shut the fuck up? We've been here 5 minutes and my head is killing me.
Has anyone spoken to Shane?
I have.
Did he say anything about what happened?
I spoke to his mom more than I spoke to him. He's not taking April's death too well.
No one would expect him to. Did you see what happened to her?
Gwen.
How would I have seen that?
Show them the picture.
Gwen, no.
There's no harm. She's already dead.
I want to see it.
Shit. I take that back. Even she didn't deserve something like that.
Did you see what was on her face?
It was a ghost face mask. From Scream.
And guess who brought up Scream 4 in class yesterday, Frankie?
So what are you trying to say? That I killed her? No fucking way! I mean, I didn't like her, but that doesn't mean I wanted to kill her.
You know, I have seen that costume lying around your house before.
Jesus Christ, everybody and their mother owns that fucking costume. I can't think of anyone that hasn't been ghost-faced once or twice at least in their life for Halloween.
He's right. When I was little, before I even knew what Scream was, I was ghost-faced for Halloween.
And there you go. Point proven.
Where the hell is Jason?
He's on his way. I don't know when he's gonna get here, though.
It's always him. It's always that fucking douchebag always keeps us waiting.
Is Shane's mom gonna be mad at us that we're really late?
I don't think so. She doesn't care when we get there, just as long as we do get there. She thinks him being around his friends will help him cope.
I think so, too. So why are we still sitting here?
I just told you why.
Can we just say fuck him and leave?
Relax, he'll be here.
Look, here he is now. What's going on?
We're gonna be fucking late. Again.
Hi, Mrs. Phillips.
Hi, Ian.
Should we come in, or...?
1 minute, I'll go get him.
Alright, thanks. Nobody bring up that picture, okay?
Damn, that was the first thing I was planning on doing. Whatever will I say now?
What?
Hey, guys.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't...
Alright,
man. You know,
I could be better.
Hi, Shane.
Frankie.
What the fuck are you doing here, you son of a bitch? Motherfucker, you fucking did this! Fucking ass!
What the fuck is your problem?
You fucking killed her!
Fuck you, I didn't kill anybody.
Bullshit, I saw your fucking shit!
Saw what? Saw what?
Ask him to roll up his sleeve. Look at his tattoo. Look at it!
Christ, it's just a fucking tattoo! You tell me how this makes me a fucking killer. That's the guy who killed April. Yeah. Okay, I'm a fan. Big fucking deal.
April was killed by someone wearing that costume. Bullshit, it wasn't you!
Come on, like, he's fucking lost his mind. Right? Is someone gonna... Right? Like that. What? You guys can all just go fuck yourselves.
Later tonight. I think it'll make you feel better.
who wants to call the cops and tell them Jason tried to kill us? Just saying. Fucking pussies. See you later, boys. What time are we coming over?
Oh, I was thinking around 9. Is that okay?
That's fine. See you then. Bye, Ian.
See you later.
Later, Gwen. What the fuck did I do now?
Can you take me somewhere real quick before I go back to my house?
Yeah, sure. Where do you want to go?
Hi, Natalie.
Hi.
Are you here to see my mom?
Well, I was, but it kind of looks like you need someone to talk to.
Oh. It's all my fault. If I would have just listened to her and stayed home, she wouldn't be dead.
Oh, that's not true. You couldn't have known anything like this would have happened.
I was so mean to her. The last thing I said was, I wish she was never my sister. And now she's dead and I'll never be able to say I'm sorry.
But you know, people say things all the time that they don't mean. It'll get better sooner or less.
But everyone hates me. My mom won't even look at me. When she does, she just screams.
It's just because she's upset. I mean, we all are. Your sister was one of my best friends, and I already miss her so much. But you know, it's gotta get better. It really has to. And I'm always here if you need to talk.
So, how's he doing?
Not so great, but he'll be okay. Eventually we all will be.
I hope so.
Yeah, I'm sure I'll be fine as long as everyone else is out there with me.
Just checking.
But, I mean, if I get really scared, would you come back inside?
Yeah, of course, if that happens.
Alright, thanks.
No problem. I'm just gonna meet you outside because I gotta get something from upstairs.
Keep your panties on.
Oh, hey, Natalie.
Hey, Frankie.
so you don't waste any time.
Are you kidding me? The hot tub is the only reason why I'm here.
His house is so nice. I can't believe I've never been here before.
Did you see where we're watching the movie?
No, where?
Look at it. It's fucking sick, right?
Oh my god, that's so cool.
No, I know, right? My mom picked it up a few months back.
Oh yeah, because last time I was here, that wasn't.
No, yeah, well, you know, given the circumstances, I figured now would be the perfect time to watch horror movies in the backyard.
What are we watching?
Well, you know, I went to the mall and bought the movie that I found most appropriate.
Yes, best fucking idea ever.
There's no way I'm watching that.
Oh, come on, Natalie. You love the Scream movies.
Yeah, but don't you think now's not really the best time to be watching those?
Come on, we'll be fine. And not to mention, I've never seen it before.
What?
I know.
Are you fucking kidding me? The master of horror films has never seen Scream movies.
I know. No, it's bad. I only saw Scream 4 last week, but I never got around to seeing the first three, so...
Well, then put it on, dude. Don't waste any more time.
Can we just wait until everyone's here?
Who are we waiting for? Didn't Shane say he wasn't coming?
Yeah, well, Jason told me he'd probably come.
After the way he stormed out of Shane's, he's not going anywhere. I guarantee he's sitting at home, crying.
Well, you know what? It wouldn't hurt to call.
Put it on speaker!
Painting so people think he's important. He doesn't waste his time being nice to people who aren't any use to him. These are my crimes.
Hello?
Hey, Jason, it's Ian. What's up, man?
What do you want?
I was wondering, are you coming tonight? Everyone's kind of here.
Yeah, I think I'm going to pass on that.
Oh, come on, man. We're watching our favorite movie.
Stop being a fucking pussy and get over here!
Who the fuck was that?
Sorry, that was Gwen.
Well, maybe you tell that bitch to keep her fucking mouth shut and I'll come. What are you guys watching?
Scream. Jason, you there?
Yeah, alright. I'll come. Just give me like 20, 30 minutes.
Alright, do you want us to wait for you to start the movie or?
Nah. Fine, I've seen it like 1,000 fucking times, so.
Alright, well, see you later, man. See you soon. Well, he is still coming, but he's not gonna be here for a little bit, but he said we can start the movie without him.
It's not like I was waiting for him anyways. But I was. So, are you just gonna wait around all night and wait for him to make a move?
Gwen, not now!
Wait, you like Ian?
Gwen, do you see what you just started?
So do you like him?
I may sort of like him a little, yeah. Fuck you.
I'm not laughing because it's funny. I'm laughing because I didn't think you liked him like that, too. Should be interesting to see how this pans out.
But just drop it for now because he's coming.
Alright, are you guys ready to start it up?
I've been ready.
Alright.
Yes. What's your favorite scary movie?
Wrong. I already know the answer to that question.
Then what do you want?
To talk to my number one fan.
You had a better idea, buddy. Go fuck yourself.
What?
You know they deserve to die. They all deserve to die.
Colin?
Mine lost its reality, buddy. You ever think of that?
You're absolutely right. I'm the first to admit, this were a scary movie, I'd be the prime suspect.
Be your mother.
Just come on in. All is
good. I'm getting all pruny.
And get out of the hot tub.
Good. Oh, but it's so nice in here.
Do you want me to put on the jets for you?
And how would that help my situation?
I'm just asking.
Where's Jason, by the way? He said he was supposed to be here half an hour ago.
Well, like you said, he's always late.
Am I ever wrong?
Ian, can you show me where your bathroom is?
Yeah, no problem. Let's go.
So, now that we're alone, you wanna...
It's hilarious how you have no game.
Fuck you.
We already did.
Your one microscopic cog in his catastrophic plan, designed and directed by his red right hand.
Sure is quiet.
Thanks.
No problem.
Oh, wait, do you think we have to go back out right a second? I mean, because, like, we could rewind the movie or something if you missed too much, but I was kind of hoping to see the rest of your house.
Yeah, no problem.
Well, this is the dining room. This is the main entrance area, like you saw before. That's, like, a sitting room.
What about upstairs?
We can go up there now. yeah, most of the house is clean, but some of it... Sorry, I've been here a couple of days. Where did
they go?
Well, a couple days ago was their 25th anniversary, and I thought that was a milestone, so they figured, hey, why not go on a 3-week trip to St. Mark?
3 weeks for one day?
Yeah, they felt it was necessary.
Okay.
That's the room with the double doors over there. This is the guest room, other guest room, and my room.
Your house is really beautiful.
Thanks.
So... why don't you show me your room?
Yeah, sure, it's right over here. So, this is my room. Sorry, it's a bit messy.
It's okay. Anybody like Friday the 13th?
Yeah, I love it. I love all kinds of horror movies, really.
Then how have you never seen Scream?
No, I really don't have an answer for that. Sorry. Sorry.
It's okay.
I want to let you know that.
Yeah, it's okay. Oh, you do.
You do?
Wait.
God, why do we have to stop? What?
I have to tell you something.
Oh, Jesus.
Gwen, no, I'm serious. Please.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I know I've said it before. It's a really big step for me. And I really, really mean it this time. And it's the last summer before college. We're going to different schools. I don't think we should have to go our separate ways. Gwen, I love you. Great.
Frankie,
See how much you care.
Frankie, I get that you care. I really do. It's just, it's not that kind of relationship, and it never will be. Where are you going?
Grabbing my stuff, going inside, and going the fuck home.
Stop being a little bitch and get over here.
You know what? Fuck you. I'm done.
Well, that shouldn't be so hard because it never fucking started! What, did you forget your fucking tampons?
You okay?
Huh?
Are you alright?
Yeah, I'm fine. I was just admiring your little paper collection over there.
Yeah, I haven't been able to go through that in a while.
It's alright, it's not so messy. At least it has some sort of organization to it. What's this?
What's what? Natalie, don't.
Why do you have this?
Please, I can explain.
Wait, but you said that you've never seen the Scream movies. Why to me? Why would you have this?
It's Natalie.
Oh my god.
Please.
Get away from me!
Explain everything. Room. It's right there.
Before.
He's got a gun. I've seen it. It's by his TV somewhere.
Oh,
Got it.
Okay. Give me the gun. Let's get the hell out of here. Get the fuck out of the way.
Shoot him!
God damn it, you shoot him!
We're gonna shoot him, Ian!
Please move!
Shoot him!
Ian, shoot the fuck. Please, just get the fuck out of the way.
Just shoot him!
Please move!
So,
I want to see who it is.
Be careful. Oh my god, it was Shane?
Fuck. Help me.
Oh,
please.
Okay.
I'm gonna go find my phone and call the police or somebody.
Never seen a dead body before. It's different in real life.
Yeah, well, I saw too.
Well, don't say that. You're gonna be okay. You're gonna be okay. Jesus, there's a lot of blood.
It's not real blood, Natalie.
No.
My move's not over yet. You ready for the extended ending? You know, I never did get to ask you. What's your favorite scary movie?
Guess, I can't find my phone. Ian, do you have yours?
It's okay. The cops aren't coming.
Ian, what the fuck?
Oh, come on, Natalie, I'm the fucking film student. I specialize in everything bloody. I'm not doing this again. We already played the cat and mouse game. Now it's time for the big climax.
Why are you doing this?
Well, I can't take all the credit. Shane helped me out.
You're sick.
I prefer the term psychotic. No, you always cared about me, Natalie. I know you did. And that is why I decided to make you the star of my movie.
What movie? Ian, this is real life. This isn't a fucking movie.
No. I've heard that line before, and it was from a movie. Nev Campbell says exactly that in Scream 4, which brings me to my next point. Scream 4. Biggest fucking disappointment of this whole year. It didn't make the money that it was expected to, so now they're just giving up. But what they don't understand is that it's not about the fucking money. There is still a story to tell, and that's all that should matter. But the opinions of the few fans that this franchise has left just isn't enough. You know, maybe they don't see the story. Maybe Kevin Williamson just has some serious writer's block. But either way, I've got their solution right here. Me. Somebody had to show the filmmakers that people still care. Us Scream fans would kill to see a Scream 5 if they cared to make it fucking awesome. Maybe all they needed was some new material, and now they've got it. I finally got to make my own personal Scream fan film. You know what? All it took was one simple fucking lie. The minute I told Shane that April was cheating on him with Jason of all fucking people, well, the kid just fucking lost his mind. He was willing to listen to anything I said.
would never cheat on Shane!
Yeah, well, that'll be our little secret. What they don't know has already hurt them.
Oh my god.
You know, I wanted to do this alone, but I knew I would not be able to pull it off. But, you know what? I can say whatever the fuck I want now. Everybody's dead. My story is the only one that's gonna count, and that's what this has always been about, Natalie. Tell me my story to the world. I'm gonna get everything I've always wanted. The credit. The Scream franchise is going to continue because of me. For generations to come, I'll be remembered as the one who really brought this franchise to life.
But they're just movies. I mean, no one's gonna think about them the way you think that they will.
See, that's where you're wrong. Movies like this have a real psycho fan base. I mean, look at me. I'm pretty fucking nuts. I can't say that I'm not. I'm going to know fame the way I've always dreamed it to be.
But why me?
Can't you see? My movie needed a star. Someone its audience could really care about. An innocent girl with shitty friends and a fucked up family. Oh yeah, family problems really, really hit home. Your parents' divorce was the key. Come on. Don't you get it? You're my Sydney! My Sydney fucking Prescott! I mean, divorce isn't as tragic as your mother died. It had to do.
Fuck you.
You already did. Now it's time to move on, Sid. My movie needs to end, and it needs to end with you.
What?
Wait, did you think that I was gonna kill you? Oh, no, Natalie, no. You're my sole survivor. Your story is just as important as mine. But you know, I'm afraid I do have to cut you up a little bit.
No!
Oh, come on, Natalie! It's just a fucking knife.
God. Get away from me! Hi there, who am I speaking to?
My name is Dolores, sir. Do you have an emergency?
Well, I wouldn't say that. It's more of a confession, really.
It's not for emergency calls only. I'm not a priest, sir. You'll have to...
I never said you fucking were, lady. For your sake, you might want to take note of every fucking word that comes out of my mouth. So let's start from the top, shall we?
My name is Ian Brody. I'm 17 years old. I live on 4 Hemlock Lane, Howell, New Jersey. And for the last 3 days, I've been responsible for a lot of fucking bloodshed. I mean, I killed Stacy Cooper, Tina Riley, beloved teacher Rachel fucking Conway, April Harris, my own brother, and dare I say more? I'm at my house right now, and I'm about to kill someone else. Come get me.
Please, you don't have to do this, please.
You know, I don't have to do anything, but that's life. We all make our own decisions. You know, I always had a thing for you, Sid. Down right now before you do something you're gonna regret.
Herodian, that's life, and this is my decision. Ugh.